Thank you for watching Back Porch Wisdom with Pastor Rob Wynn. We pray that this weekly broadcast will be a blessing to you. And now here is Pastor Rob Wynn with today's message.
Hi, this is Pastor Rob Wynn. Welcome you to Back Porch Wisdom today. And I'm talking about Mrs. Barbara Bug Compton and how she had led me to the Lord and how she exemplified the life of a disciple of Jesus Christ. Some 40, maybe 50 years ago, she was going to church, but she wasn't born again. And so a lady named Mrs. Reverend, no, Reverend Jean Spikes came to their little church in Nanafly, Alabama. And she led Miss Barbara to the Lord and got her baptized in the Holy Ghost, praying in other tongues. And Miss Barbara began to live a holy life, separated unto God. She really exemplified abiding in Christ and His Word abiding in her, and her asking what she will and Him doing it for her. And she had 3 points to her first sermon: God is altogether good, I am responsible, and the Word of God is living. And so in talking about that, we use John 10:10, the thief comes not but for to kill, steal, and destroy, and I've come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. And right there he calls himself the Good Shepherd in verse 11. And in John 3, you find that if you live, her example was to lift Jesus up. So in John 3:14 it says, Jesus says, just as Moses lifted up the snake in the wilderness, so the Son of Man must be lifted up, that everyone who believes may have eternal life in Him. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him shall not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through Him. And she knew that. She knew Jesus so well. She knew that the tragedies that had happened in her life were not from Him. They weren't from God. They weren't in the plan. We're just in a fallen world, and accidents happen. Disease is in the world. You see that now just recently with this virus that's going around, killing people. And that's not the will of God. The will of God is that you have life and have it more abundantly. But see, I am responsible. God is altogether good. I am responsible. And the Word of God is living were her first messages. So I am responsible means that we follow Jesus' way. In Romans, the 8th chapter, the first verse, it says, there is therefore now no condemnation to those that are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh but after the Spirit. And so her endeavor in life was not to be ruled and reigned by this world, but to be ruled and reigned by the world that Jesus brought down to earth, called His heavenly kingdom. And so she tried to walk as the being from heaven that she was. And so in Luke 6:40, here's why she said, I am responsible. A pupil is not superior to his teacher, but everyone, when he is completely trained, readjusted, restored, set right, and perfected. Now, perfected, we think nobody could be perfect but Jesus, but Jesus was perfect in that He didn't sin, and we do sin. But it's talking about maturity there. It's not talking about never doing anything wrong. We'll be like His teacher. And so she knew from that example as a believer that Jesus set the standard. You find in Ephesians chapter 4, I believe it is, where it says that the ministry gifts are to bring people into the fullness of the measure of stature of Christ unto a perfect man. And she knew that there was a goal, and the goal was to press in to Jesus. And that this world, like Paul said, you know, some translations call it trash. No, it's dumb. Paul thought everything that he had naturally, he accounted as dung, so that he could grab a hold of Jesus Christ and live in Him and for Him. And so she knew Him. She knew, I am responsible, because of Hebrews 13, verse 20 and 21, where it's exemplified Jesus as the great shepherd. It says, "Now may the God of peace, who through the blood of the eternal covenant brought back from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, equip you with everything good for doing His will, and may He work in us what is pleasing to Him." We're talking about walking in faith. "Through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen." And she knew this scripture, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 4, it says that everyone of you should know how to possess his own vessel. That means your body and your mind and your spirit, in sanctification and in honor. And we've talked about that before. Sanctification means you walk in consecration to God every day. And so it's important that you know God is altogether good. I am responsible. And the Word of God is living. Listen, Jesus, in Jesus' own words, in Matthew 18, He said, "All power and authority has been given to me in heaven and earth. You go, therefore, teaching everyone to observe whatever I've commanded you to do. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the earth." And then you find in Mark 16, verse 17, He says, "And these signs shall follow them that believe." It names all these different signs, like casting out devils, speaking in new tongues. If anything you ingest, it won't harm you. And then the last verse says, "And they went everywhere proclaiming, the Lord working with them," are working with His Word, with signs following. Amen. And so, if you've never asked Jesus into your heart, today is the day to ask Jesus into your heart. If you're backslidden, you know you're walking in sin, then it's time to turn around and do an 180 degrees turn and walk with Jesus. So, pray this with me. Say, "Heavenly Father, I believe that Jesus is Lord and that You raised Him from the dead so that I could be saved, so that I could be Your child. I believe that in my heart, and I've said it with my mouth as You said I'm required to do. And now I'm in right standing with You. In Jesus' name, amen." Well, go on my website, Cornerstone Church, the number 4, the letter U.com. And watch my videos. And if you like the video, share it to a group. If you don't like it, if I tag you and you don't like it, just block me or something. But it's all about the message. It's not anything about me. I'm just a messenger boy. And so if you're in the Tuscaloosa area, Pastor Bobby Bonner's recording me, and his website is RevolutionBibleChurch.org. Come to our church. We want to have you. God bless you and have a good day.
If you're ever in the Linden, Alabama area, we invite you to worship with us at Cornerstone Church. For more information and other resources, visit our website at CornerstoneChurchForYou.com.